Welcome to our channel, Engineer's Choice Tutor. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the receive-only TV system. Okay, what we are going to discuss? Receive-only home TV system in satellite communication. So basically here we are going to discuss about the earth segment of satellite communication system. Okay, so basically earth segment of a satellite communication system consists of transmit earth station and receive earth station. Okay, so earth segment of a satellite communication system consists of transmit earth station and receive earth station. So planned broadcasting directly to home TV receivers taken place in KU band, means 12 gigahertz frequency. Okay, and this service is also known as direct broadcast satellite service, means DBS service. Okay, it is clear. Now next, so now we are going to see the block diagram of a home terminal for DBS TV FM reception. Okay, so this is basically the block diagram. You see this line divides the upper part is what outdoor unit, and the inner means lower part is what indoor unit. Indoor unit means satellite receiver, that setup box, you know, that setup box in your home, that is nothing but the satellite receiver. And the up antenna part is what, that is the outdoor unit, which consists of a parabolic reflector and receive horn and polarizer and low noise amplifier and converter. Okay, so we first discuss about the outdoor unit, then we discuss about the indoor unit. Okay, so the outdoor unit consists of a receiving antenna. This is our receiving antenna. Okay, so the outdoor unit consists of a receiving antenna feeding directly into the low noise, feeding directly into the low noise amplifier converter combination. Okay, you see the signal is coming. This signal is of the range of 12.2 to 12.7 gigahertz. Okay, this signal after the means this signal is first coming to the receiving antenna, and after that it is fed into the which low noise amplifier and converter combination. Okay, so this is basically a parabolic reflector. You see, this is the parabolic reflector. Okay, so a parabolic reflector is generally used with a receiving horn mounted at the focus. Okay, this is the horn mounted at the focus. So basically this reflector diameter is in the range of 0.6 to 1.6 meter, and the two nominal sizes often quoted are 0.9 meter and 1.2 meter. Okay, so the gain of the parabolic dish is proportional to d upon lambda ka whole square. Okay, so the downlink frequency band of 12.2 to 12.7 gigahertz spans a range of 500 megahertz, which accommodates 32 TV FM channels, each of which is 24 megahertz wide. It is clear. Now some overlap occurs between channel, but these are alternatively polarized left hand circular and right hand circular, or vertical yeah horizontal, to reduce interference to acceptable levels. Okay, this is referred to as polarization interleaving. So basically a polarizer, this polarizer that may be switched to the desired polarization from the indoor control unit. From the indoor control unit, we can switch this polarizer to the desired polarization. Okay, from the indoor unit is required at the receiving horn. It is clear. Now the receiving horn feeds into the combination. Now this receiving horn feeds into the combination unit consisting of low noise amplifier followed by the converter. We usually refer this combination. This combination we usually referred as LNB. LNB means low noise block. Okay, so LNB, what this LNB provide? So LNB provides gain for the broadband 12 GHz signal and then convert the signal to a lower range so that the low-cost coaxial cable can be used as a feeder to the indoor unit. It is clear? So the standard frequency range of this down converted signal, okay, after the conversion, what signal we got? That down converted signal is of the range that is 950 to 1450 megahertz. Okay, so the coaxial cable, this coaxial cable is used to carry DC power to the, see, this same coaxial cable is used to carry the DC power. This DC power is the arrow upward, means the coaxial cable is used to carry the DC power to the outdoor unit. Okay, polarization switching control wires are also required. It is clear? Now we discuss about the indoor unit. First I will give you the notes of the outdoor unit. So this is the notes of the outdoor unit. You can write it, okay, for your exam. Note it down. Now next we will discuss what? We will discuss about the indoor unit. So let's go to the image itself to understand better. Okay, so for the indoor unit, I want to mention few points. So the signal that is fed to the indoor unit, okay, to the indoor unit is normally a wide band signal, okay, covering 950 to 1450 megahertz. Okay, so this is amplified and passed to the tracking filter. Here the amplifier, what it will do? It will amplify this signal and pass it to the tracking filter, which selects the desired channel. Okay, so the selected channel is again down converted. The selected channel is again down converted, this time from 950 to 1450 megahertz range to a fixed intermediate frequency. Okay, usually 70 megahertz. Okay, although other values in the very high frequency range are also used. So the 70 megahertz amplifier amplifies the signal up to the level required for demodulation. The 70 megahertz FM intermediate frequency carrier must be demodulated and the baseband information used to generate a VSSB signal. VSSB signal means what? Vestigial signal side band. Okay, which is fed into one of the VHF. VHF means very high frequency and UHF means ultra high frequency channels of a standard TV set. Okay, so the demodulated video and audio signals are usually made available at the output jack, and that output jack you can connect with the TV and you can use your TV. Okay, you can get the benefit of the dish. So that is about the indoor unit. Okay, that is about the indoor unit. So see, this is all about what? Indoor unit. It is clear? So basically I want to mention one more point. So a major difference between DBS TV and conventional TV is that with DBS, frequency modulation is used. Okay, which type of modulation we are using? Frequency modulation is used, whereas with conventional TV, amplitude modulation in the form of VSSB is used. Okay, this point is made. You can point it down. Okay, note it down, this point. So I hope everything is clear to you. So thank you for watching our video. Subscribe the channel and like the video. Thank you.